the marine diesel engine. For sailors, it comes to our rescue on windless days. For powerboaters, it's the most critical and expensive asset on board. Feed these beasts with clean fuel, and soon enough you are drinking sundowners in paradise. But if water gets into that fuel supply, that wonderful diesel engine will cut out immediately, creating all sorts of unwanted drama, often at the worst possible time, like running from a storm, or arriving at the dock with Mr. or Ms. Charming looking on. Follow along to learn the simple steps we use to ensure a clean supply of fuel to our engine on board our sailboat Sea Rose.
First thing you'll need is some latex gloves. I got a roll of paper towels here. And also I've got a glass jar that I'm going to drain the fuel into, and glass so that I can see through it to see if I've got any water within the fuel. So it might be obvious to you, but you know, the fuel's going to float on top of the water. Fuel oil is lighter than water. So you'll see a separation layer. It's not always from the color. Some of the color looks similar. If you're not sure, drain a little bit more off, because you could be getting water and water and water in there and you don't know. As you get used to it, you'll be able to read a little bit the color of diesel. Diesel's going to be a little bit more of a beige color, a slightly non-clear color. It depends. Some places dye their fuel, and it's going to be really clear if they dye the off-road diesel, say in pink or something like that. You're going to really tell easily. Here in Europe, it's a very, very light tan color. So it's hard sometimes to tell that between that and water. But we'll check it out today.
Okay, so let's get familiar with fuel water separators.
Okay, so here is our first filter. Sometimes they call this a primary filter because on the engine there's a secondary filter. But regardless, you'll often see two filters in a diesel engine. And the first filter that comes in from the tank is typically a water separator as well. So the water will accumulate down below. This is, I'm not sure the brand of this filter. Raycor is a really popular brand in the United States, and they have a kind of a glass bottom, and you can see, you can see dirt and grit in your fuel. You can see, you can kind of see if you get up close, you can see that if there's water there or not. This assemblage came with a black kind of case that went around it and all the way down below. I've taken that off because I'm checking this like every week or two to see if there's any water in the fuel. But normally you'd want to leave that casing on. It protects the little nipple at the bottom and anything from jarring it and then causing a fuel leak.
Okay, now it's time to take a sample of fuel.
Okay, so yeah, definitely your setup will vary depending on what kind of filter you have. On this, there's a little plastic nipple at the bottom. And so it's a matter of taking my glass jar, and I'll try to keep my hands out of the way so you can see what's going on, but I'm going to hold the glass jar underneath. I'm just going to open up that nipple so I get a little bit of flow of fuel coming down. And this nipple, when you tighten it back up, you don't need to really crank hard on it. It seals itself pretty well. So now you can see a little bit of fuel coming out. It looks to me like it's got a little bit of bronze color to it, but so it's probably all fuel oil. All right, close that up. Now these wires, this one's set up with a sensor so that if water does accumulate in here, it's gonna send off an alarm so you know that something's wrong, and the engine will still run for a little while after that. So that's kind of a nice feature.
And now let's inspect that sample we took.
All right, so when we look, you can definitely see now that there's a separation of water and fuel, and there's a little layer of fuel oil, maybe a half an inch tall there. So it was a good idea we did this, took the time to figure it out and make sure of what we were looking at. And actually, you know, you could mistake in the lower stuff, since it's a bronze color, it could be it could be mistaken as fuel oil if we didn't keep going. So there you go.
Before we're done, we need to reprime the fuel system.
So for this this setup, you would prime the engine again, and it's really easy. Just press down on this pumper here until it gets stiff, and that takes the gap of air that we let into the system and pressurizes and pushes it all the way through. a good diesel engine runs really well if it's got clean fuel and pressure compression, and it doesn't take much else besides that. Good cooling, I suppose. But clean fuel is one of the biggest problems on a boat.
That's it. As always, we hope you enjoyed this video, and we encourage you to like it so others can more easily find this kind of content. Be sure to check out our playlist of other how-to videos on our Life 4.0 channel, as well as our many sailing adventure videos, as we explore this amazing planet one anchorage at a time.